Hello to all, good morning to all, good morning, how you all are, good, going well, yes, so today we are going to complete the principal stress, right, today we are going to complete the principal stress, okay, so let's start. So, in the strength of material, we were studying about the principal stress, right? And we have seen what is strain transformation, how we are going to see from stress to strain, how we are going to find the principal strain, right? Now, I'm going to start a topic today first. Then I will see with the questions. Okay. That topic will be strain transformation, and that is strain rosette. That topic will be strain rosette. Okay, so can you tell me what is strain rosette? Yes, can you tell me what is strain rosette? Have you heard about this term strain rosette? Yes, have you heard about this term strain rosette? What is strain rosette? What is strain rosette? Those who are new, I'm clearly saying this is the sixth module of the principal stress chapter, right? This is the sixth module. Since today I'm talking about the strain transformation, so I'm dealing with it. That's why I'm dealing with the strain transformation today. Okay. So what is strain rosette? What is strain rosette? What is strain rosette? Tell me. What is strain rosette? What is strain rosette? Can anyone tell? Yes. What is strain rosette? Okay. Just try to understand. See. Just listen to me. What I am saying that theoretically due to the applied load, theoretically when we design, due to the applied load, we determine the principal stress. Okay. But in the field, if I have to determine the principal stress, then I need to determine the principal strain first. I need to determine principal strain first. Is it clear? I need to determine principal strain first. Okay. Now from the principal strain, we determine the principal stress. Now, how can I determine the principal strain? How can I determine the principal strain? So this principal strain can be determined by the normal strain and shear strain that is acting at a point. What I'm saying that principal strain at a point can be determined by finding the normal and shear strain at that point. Is it clear? By finding the normal and shear strain at that point. Okay. So in the field, how normal strain is measured? The normal strain is measured with the help of normal strain gauge. Okay. The normal strain is measured with the help of normal strain gauge. Whereas shear strain is measured with the help of shear strain gauge. Yes or no? No, it's not like that. What happens here? Normal strain gauge is very sensitive. Okay. It gives very accurate results. But shear strain gauge is not as sensitive as that of the normal strain gauge. Sensitive means accuracy. Okay. So shear strain gauge is not that accurate. Are you getting my point? So what happened in the field? We don't measure the shear strain with the help of the shear strain gauge, but instead we take the combination of three normal strain gauges. We take a combination of three normal strain gauges to determine the shear strain at any point. Yes. So this combination is referred as strain rosette. Okay. So that is just a part. Let me write. You will understand what I'm saying that. To measure principal stress, practically principal strains
are required. Okay, this is the first point. Now, to determine principal strain, normal and shear strain. At that point, should be known. Okay, are you getting my point now? Now, what I'm saying that, well, for normal strain. Normal strain gauge is used, which is very sensitive, and is accurate up to 1 × 10⁻⁶. Okay, but for shear strain gauge, is not as sensitive. Hence, instead a combination of three normal strain gauges are used to determine shear strain. Is it clear? Right. So this combination is referred as strain rosette. Is it clear? This we say as a strain rosette. Is it clear? So the combination of three normal strain gauges is referred as strain rosette. Just read this. What I am saying that in order to measure the principal stress practically, principal strains are required. Okay. Now this principal strain, for determining the principal strain, normal and shear strain at the point should be known. Okay. For normal strain, we use the normal strain gauge because it is very sensitive and very accurate. This accuracy is up to after decimal 6 digits. But shear strain is not as sensitive. So what we do instead of shear strain gauge, we use a combination of three normal strain gauge in order to determine the shear strain. So this combination is referred as strain rosette. Is it clear? Is the definition clear to all? Okay. So this is strain rosette. Now, I have told you one thing that in the start that to determine principal stress, principal strain is required. Okay, so let's see how to get this. First, I'm writing determination of principal stress
principal stress from principal strain, from principal strain. How you can determine principal stress from principal strain? See, we know one thing. Suppose this is a structural element subjected to the principal stress of sigma p1, okay, and sigma p2, sigma p1 and sigma p2. So what I can write about epsilon p1? Yes, come on here, come on, write. Tell me what I can write about epsilon p1. Yes, what I can write about epsilon p1? What I can write about epsilon p1? Say, man, what I can write about epsilon p1? Yes, what I can write about epsilon p1? Nothing but sigma p1 by E minus mu sigma p2 by E. Yes or no? Sigma p1 by E minus mu sigma p2 by E. So this is my first equation. Okay, similarly, what I am going to write about epsilon p2? Nothing but sigma p2 by E minus mu sigma p1 by E. Yes or no? So I have two equation. Okay, I have two equation. Now I need to find sigma p1 in terms of epsilon p1, p2 and mu. I need to find epsilon p1 in terms, that is sigma p1 in terms of epsilon p1, p2 and mu. That means I need to eliminate sigma p2. Okay, I need to eliminate sigma p2. So what I am going to do, just see here, if I multiply 2 with mu, okay, and add 2 1. Now think about this, what I am doing. Sigma p2 by E in the first equation has a coefficient of u, mu, right, with a minus sign. And in the second equation, sigma p2 by E has a coefficient of only 1. So I multiplied it with mu and add 2 1. So what will happen? So what will happen? In the LHS, it will be epsilon p1 plus mu times epsilon p2. This will be equal to sigma p1 by E minus mu sigma p2 by E plus mu sigma p2 by E minus mu square sigma p1 by E. Yes or no? Yes or no? Say it here. So what get cancelled out? Minus mu sigma p2 by E minus mu sigma p2 by E. Yes or no? So it cancelled out. Then if I take sigma p1 by E common, I will get 1 minus mu square. Yes or no? So from here, what you get? Sigma p1, nothing but E upon 1 minus mu square into epsilon p1 plus mu times epsilon p2. Yes or no? Yes or no? So sigma p1 you get as E upon 1 minus mu square epsilon p1 plus mu times epsilon p2. Now, can you see that if you know epsilon p1, p2, you can find sigma p1? Yes or no? Similarly, if I need to find sigma p2, what I can write? E upon 1 minus mu square epsilon p2 plus mu times epsilon p1. The place where 1 is there, I replace with 2. The place where 2 is there, I replace with 1. Got my point? Yes. So this formula you need to remember. They may ask question on this. Okay. So determination of principal, what I did, the first question that I said, how can I find? If I know principal strain, how can I directly give the principal stress? So this is the answer. Yes. Is it clear? Yes or no? So what I did, I just replaced the values, rearranged the values, and I've written in terms of sigma p1 and sigma p2. Is it clear? Okay. Now, one more case that I'm going to add. Just have a look. Any doubt, please ask. Otherwise, I will move on. Yes? Any doubt you are having?
Today after this, we are going to solve the questions on the strain. Yes, any doubt you are having? Say dear. Any doubt? Any doubt? Any doubt you are having? Please ask. Okay. Now see here. If the question is given plain stress condition. Plain stress condition. In this only I am talking. So if the plain stress condition is there, that means your sigma P3, your sigma P3 is equal to 0, yes or no? We know that sigma P3 will be equal to 0, but the strain in the third direction is not equal to 0, and we have seen that it is given by minus mu by E sigma P1 plus sigma P2, if you remember. Yes or no? We have seen this. Yes, we have seen this. Yes or no? Okay. Now see then. So what I'm going to write? Minus mu by E. Now we have the value of epsilon P1 and P2. Yes or no? And in that value, you can see that. Both if I'm adding sigma P1 and sigma P2, E upon 1 minus mu square is common. Yes or no? So I'm taking it out. E upon 1 minus mu square. Why to take it inside? No need. Okay, now write the inside terms. That is epsilon P1 plus mu epsilon P2 plus epsilon P2 plus mu epsilon P1. Okay. So this is the value you are getting. Now from this, what I can write? E get cancelled out. I will get minus mu upon 1 minus mu square. If I take epsilon P1, I will get epsilon P1 times 1 plus mu plus epsilon P2 times 1 plus mu. Yes or no? So from both, you can see that I can take 1 plus mu out. So minus mu upon 1 minus mu square into 1 plus mu into epsilon P1 plus epsilon E2. Okay. So you can see the form of A square minus B square in the denominator. So that I can write as A plus B into A minus B. So what formula will be left? Nothing but A minus B, that is 1 minus mu, multiply with epsilon P1 plus epsilon P2. Got the point? So in the plane stress condition, if you know the principal strain in the two direction, you can find the principal strain in the third direction. Is it clear? And the principal stress is 0. And the principal stress is 0. Yes, any doubt in this? How we will be determining the principal stress from the principal strain? Yes, any doubt you are having? Any doubt, please ask. Any doubt? Any doubt you are having? Yes? Okay, done? Got it. Now, what I said, this was my first point, no? This was my first point. I proved the first point that to measure the principal stress, practically principal strains are required. Okay. Now, for principal strain, what I said, for principal strain, the normal and shear strain at that point should be known. Okay. So for normal strain, what I'm saying, normal strain gauge. I will use the normal strain gauge for finding the normal strain. But for shear strain, I cannot use the normal strain gauge. I will be using the shear strain gauge. But instead we'll use the combination of three normal strain gauge for determining the shear strain. This combination is referred as strain rosette. So now I am going to show you different combinations
of strain rosette. Different combinations of strain rosette. Okay, we need to see the different combinations of strain rosette. Okay, just see to it. The first combination, what I've told to you, there are different combinations, okay? And these combinations will consist of three normal strain gauge. So first strain rosette that I'm going to write is 45 degree strain rosette. 45 degree strain rosette. 45 degree strain rosette. Okay. So what is this 45 degree strain rosette? Try to understand. First strain, normal strain gauge, I will use along the X axis. Okay. So I will be measuring normal strain. So I'm writing epsilon. And that too, I have already told you that in the strain transformation, I will take angle with respect to horizontal. And this particular strain is along the horizontal. So the angle of this particular strain gauge with respect to horizontal is 0 degree. So I'm writing epsilon 0. Are you able to get my point? Yes or no? What I'm saying? I'm keeping the strain gauge along the X direction. Okay, that is in the horizontal. So since it is measuring the normal strain, I'm writing epsilon. And since it is angle of 0 degree with respect to horizontal, I'm writing 0. Because I've already told you, discussed in the previous lecture, that the strain in the strain transformation, the angle will be taken with respect to the horizontal. Yes. Now next is, at an angle of 90 degree. The next is at an angle of 90 degree. Okay. And the third will be at an angle of, and the third will be at an angle of 45 degree. Third will be at an angle of 45 degree. So you will measure the normal strain at 45 degree. Okay. Now just try to understand. This epsilon naught I can write as epsilon x. Okay, this epsilon 90 I can write as epsilon y. Okay, so for writing the principal strain, see, for a principal strain we are going to write epsilon p1 p2, that is equal to epsilon x plus epsilon y by 2 plus minus root over epsilon x minus epsilon y by 2 whole square plus phi xy by 2 whole square, if you remember. So for that equation I require only phi xy from this particular strain rosette. Okay, so we have to frame one equation in which phi xy should be unknown. Getting the point? So what I am writing? What is the formula for epsilon 45? Yes? What formula you are going to write? Epsilon x cos square theta? Yes or no? That we can write what? That is what? If I substitute the values also, suppose you substitute the values also, so epsilon naught cos square 45, yes or no, plus epsilon 90, because epsilon y is equal to epsilon 90, epsilon 90 sin square 45 plus phi xy cos 45 into sin 45. So in this equation, come on, reply, how many unknowns are there? In this equation, come on, reply, how many unknowns are there? In this equation, how many unknowns are there? Yes, in this equation, how many unknowns are there? Only one, yes or no? There is only one unknown, that is phi xy, because we have find the epsilon 45 with the normal strain gauge. We found epsilon naught, epsilon 90, right? 45 is there. So the only remaining is phi xy, that is unknown to you, that you will find from this equation, and then you can find the value of principal strain. Okay. So that is the first question. First combination. Second combination is
60 degree strain rosin. Now you can draw, I think you can draw the 60 degree strain rosin. Yes, if you know the 45 degree, then you can draw the 60 degree also. So how the 60 degree will look like? One will be at 0 degree. Yes or no? So that is epsilon 0. Other will be at angle of 90 degree. That is epsilon 90. And third will be at an angle of. Third will be at an angle of 60 degrees. So I'm writing that as epsilon 60. And the angle that you are going to see will be 60 degree with respect to the horizontal. Got my point? So angle you will be seeing as 60 degree with respect to the horizontal, right? So I think you can understand that instead of 45, 60 has come. So again, one unknown will be there that you can determine. Okay. Let us see the third one. Third combination. Third combination is 120 degree strain rosin. Third combination is 120 degree strain rosin. Third combination is 120 degree strain rosin. So what is the basic difference? Try to understand. What is the basic difference? So epsilon naught, epsilon 90 will remain same. Yes or no? Epsilon naught. And epsilon 90 will remain same. One more strain gauge will be applied at angle of 120 degree with respect to the horizontal. 120 degree with respect to the horizontal. Okay. So this is the another strain gauge where the strain is measured in the 120 degree with respect to the horizontal, right? So again, the only one unknown is there, you can find phi xy. Is it clear? Now that was the third one. Let us look at the fourth one. From the fourth one, the question has been asked in ESE conventional. So fourth is delta strain rosette. Fourth is delta strain rosette. So what is delta strain rosette? See here, one normal strain gauge will be along x direction, so that is epsilon 0. Another will be at an angle of 60 degree to the horizontal in clockwise direction. 60 degree with respect to horizontal in, anti-clockwise direction, right? And the third will be at an angle of 120 degree with respect to the horizontal. Okay. So, this is epsilon 0, then epsilon 60, then epsilon 120. Okay. So, how many unknowns are there for finding the principal strain? Yes. How many unknowns are there for finding the principal strain? How many unknowns are there for finding the principal strain? How many unknowns are there for finding the principal strain? See, you don't know epsilon 90. You don't know phi xy. So there are two unknowns. Okay. So first of all, I'm writing epsilon 60. So what is epsilon 60? Nothing but epsilon naught cos square 60. Plus epsilon 90 sine square 60. Epsilon 90 sine square 60 plus phi xy into cos 60 into sine 60. Okay. So that is epsilon 60. Next, what is epsilon 120? What is epsilon 120? Nothing but epsilon naught cos square 120 plus epsilon 90 sine square 120 plus phi xy into cos 120 into sin 120. Is it clear? So now you have two equations, okay, and you are having two unknowns. You are having two equations, you are having two unknown. So can you solve the value of epsilon 90 and phi xy? Yes, can you solve the value of epsilon 90 and phi xy? Said here, can you solve the value of epsilon 90 and phi xy? And can you get the value of principal strain? And can you get the value of principal strain? Yes. Okay. So that was the fourth, that is delta strain rosette. Next. Fifth, I'm talking about. That is star strain rosette. Star strain rosette. So what is a star strain rosette? Try to understand. One will be at 0 degree. That is epsilon 0. The second will be at an angle of 120 degree. So I'm writing epsilon 120. And the third will be at an angle of 240. So I'm writing epsilon 240. Okay, what I'm saying that one will be at an angle of 120 degree and the second will be at an angle of 240 degree. So again, there will be two unknown, that is phi xy and epsilon 90 for finding the principal strain. Yes or no? So what I'm going to write for epsilon 120? Nothing but epsilon naught cos square 120 plus epsilon 90 sin square 120 plus phi xy into cos 120 into sin 120. Is it clear? So this becomes your epsilon 120. Next, if I talk about epsilon 240, so what we can write? Epsilon naught cos square 240 plus epsilon 90 sin square 240 plus phi xy into cos of 240 into sin of 240. Yes or no? So from here, you can find, from these two equations, you can find the value of epsilon 90 and phi xy. And once you find the value of epsilon 90 and phi xy, with epsilon naught already known to you, you can find the value of principal stress. Yes, first principal strain, then principal stress. Is it clear? So is the concepts of